Simon & Schuster Audio presents The Green Witch, your complete guide to the natural magic of herbs, flowers, essential oils, and more, by Arin Murphy-Hiscock. Read by Gabra, Zackman. Introduction. Whatever your reasons for seeking balance, you'll find that harmonizing yourself with the energy of nature can help you break free from the stressors in your life and focus on the here and now. And there is no better way to explore the bounty of nature than by following the path of the Green Witch. The way of the Green Witch is the path of the naturalist, the herbalist, and the healer. It is a free-form, flexible, and personalized practice for anyone who wants to explore the gifts of nature and use them to find balance and harmony in life. With the Green Witch, you'll find the information you need to develop and nurture the spiritual practice of green witchcraft, from advice on walking the green path in the modern world to information on essential herbs, plants, trees, stones, and more. You will find recipes, exercises, ritual suggestions, and directions for making potions and herbal blends for purposes both mundane and magical. From issues such as the history of the practice to creating your own individual traditions, the Green Witch is a positive and practical guide for the modern green witch trying to connect with nature in today's society. What is so relevant and unique about green witchcraft is that it is a highly specialized and solo practice. Not everyone will be drawn to the same things and practice in the same way. It's about finding a workable balance in your own life, within your own setting. The Green Witch works closely with nature and its gifts. She uses natural elements to improve the well-being of the physical body, the spirit, and the environment, and works to establish a personal connection with the natural world. It may seem like a challenge to harmonize with nature in today's technological and industrial world. Fortunately, you don't need to remove or reverse modern influences. What you need to do is discover how to connect your modern life to that earlier knowledge that is waiting for you to find it again. The trick is to recognize the presence of green energy in the world today and to see how it still operates. Listen to the world around you. Open your heart. Rebalance. And enjoy your journey. Note, although the Green Witch and reader are referred to as she throughout this text, the path by no means excludes male practitioners, who are more common every day. The pronoun she was chosen simply for convenience. Part 1. Discovering the Green Witch. Chapter 1. What is green witchcraft? Historically, a green witch lived apart, using the energies of plants and trees around her to heal others. Those who needed her services traveled to see her. These days, a green witch is more likely to be living in the middle of a city or in the suburbs. She could work in any of a variety of fields, such as business, medicine, or teaching, or might be a full-time mom. A green witch isn't defined by where she lives or what she does to bring home a paycheck. Nor is she limited to working with plants, trees, or herbs. She is not, as people might assume, defined solely by the particular way she expresses her spirituality or by the religion she follows. A green witch is defined by her relationship to the world around her, by her ethics, and by her affinity with the natural world. In essence, she lives the life of a green witch. She lives the green path. The path of the green witch is an intensely personal path that integrates ability, likes and dislikes, the climate of a particular geographic location, and interaction with the energy of that environment. It isn't a tradition so much as a personal adaptation of an ideal. The path of the green witch. In popular perception, the practice of green witchcraft is a nature-based expression of spirituality that focuses on the individual's interaction with his or her natural environment. Witchcraft itself is a practice that involves the use of natural energies as an aid to accomplishing a task or reaching a goal. In general, Witchcraft acknowledges a god and a goddess, sometimes solely a goddess, and recognizes that magic is a natural phenomenon. Witchcraft is frequently confused with Wicca, which is a modern, alternative, nature-based religion. While Wicca and witchcraft possess many similarities, including reverence for nature, Wicca is a specific, formal religion. There is a wide variety of forms of witchcraft with varying degrees of structure. For the sake of this book, the term witchcraft refers to the practice of working with natural energies to attain goals, without a specific religious context. A green witch, then, is someone who lives the green path and is aware of how the energy of nature flows through her life and environment, even if that environment is not the traditional garden and forest setting popularized by fairy tales and romanticized notions. Why do we use the phrase living the path instead of simply saying practicing green witchcraft? It's very simple. Green witchcraft is not a practice separate from ordinary life, like ritual magic, for example. It is an all-encompassing, total immersion experience wherein all of life is a magical experience. Green witchcraft is not a formal tradition in the sense of Gardnerian Wicca, Dianic Wicca, fairy tradition, or other established forms. When we use the phrase the green witch tradition, we do not refer to an unbroken line of initiates or an established body of lore. Instead, we are referring to the various practices from diverse places that come together to inform the modern green witch and wise woman. Because the path of the green witch is an individualized solo practice, any modern book on green witchcraft is simply a single author's way of interpreting the practice. Initiation into green witchcraft is technically impossible. There exists no body of formal knowledge passed on through careful training, no established group mind to which you are connected by sacred ceremonies performed by elders. Some modern eclectic groups may base their regular practice on the ideals of green witchcraft, but it's not the same thing. A practitioner of green witchcraft may pass on her personal knowledge, including her personal notes and writings, to another, but that's not an initiatory process. Reading a specific author's ideas and views concerning the path of the green witch is a form of apprenticeship, in which you learn a new way of looking at your world and discover new exercises and techniques that will help you refine and deepen your connection to the natural world around you. This process cannot be as intensely personal as traditional apprenticeship, where the apprentice worked beside the master, but it is a modern form of acquiring the knowledge and skills of one particular practitioner. The Green Witch's Outlook. The concepts of healing, harmony, and balance are all key to the Green Witch's practice and outlook on life. These concepts embody three distinct focuses. 1. The Earth, your local environment as well as the planet. 2. Humanity, in general as well as your local community and circles of friends and acquaintances. 3. Yourself. The Earth is often singled out as the Green Witch's main focus, which is slightly unfair. The Green Witch understands that the Earth incorporates the planet and all living things upon it, including animals, plants, and people. In this respect, yes, the Earth is a collective term for all living things. However, the Green Witch also knows that to lump them all together means that we sometimes forget the more individual emphasis each deserves. We can decry the general mistreatment of our planet's water supply, but local action often has more of an immediate effect on our environment than demonstrating in front of an office tower. Clean up your own backyard is a phrase the Green Witch understands well. People are also the Green Witch's province. The modern Green Witch understands that humanity impacts the natural world, not only through how individuals treat it, but also via the energy created by their feelings and beliefs. Just as nature's energy affects us, so too does our energy affect nature, and that effect isn't always positive. Therefore, the Green Witch seeks to maintain harmony between humanity and nature. She also understands that people affect other people with their energy, and she strives to maintain a harmonious, energetic environment in which people can feel calm and empowered to improve themselves in a positive fashion and interact with each other with ease and love. Finally, the Green Witch must function in harmony with the realities of her own life. This means working out your own goals and obstacles, and knowing your own self so that you can apply your energies and skills to the best of your ability. Your true self is not necessarily the self you wish you could be. It is the self you actually are. Finding
this true self. We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.